Many years ago, in the village of Nazareth, there lived a peasant girl named Mary. She was faithful, kind-hearted, and virtuous. She was pledged to marry a strong young carpenter named Joseph. One day, while Mary was praying, the angel Gabriel appeared before her. Startled, not knowing what to expect, she trembled with fear. "Do not be afraid, Mary," the angel said. "God has chosen you to be the mother of his son. The child will be called Jesus. He will be a great servant to all, and his kingdom will never end." The angel also visited Mary's betrothed Joseph while he was dreaming. The angel told Joseph that God had chosen him to be the guardian of his son and asked him to look after Mary and the heavenly baby. Mary and Joseph were soon married. And there was a great feast and celebration with all their family and friends. Soon it was time for the baby to be born. Joseph was a carpenter, so he made wooden toys for the baby. Mary sewed clothes and blankets for the baby. But this baby would not be born at home. A Roman emperor ordered that people return to their home of birth to pay taxes. This meant that Joseph and Mary would have to go on a long journey. Joseph came from Bethlehem, and even though it was close to the time the baby would be born, Joseph and Mary had to travel 70 miles to reach Bethlehem. Joseph loaded their donkey with the supplies they would need, and they traveled for days under the desert sun. At night, they camped in the desert. When the sun went down, they were so cold. After several days, Mary and Joseph arrived in Bethlehem. The sun was setting. The town was overflowing with visitors. Eagerly, the couple stopped at the first inn they saw, but it was already full. "There's no room at the inn," called the innkeeper. They walked down the narrow streets, asking at every home and lodging along the way, but there was no room. "There's no room. Please go away. We are all full," they cried. Finally, they came to the edge of town. This was their last hope. "I'm sorry," the owner of the inn told them. "We have no room." "Please," pleaded Joseph. "My wife is about to have a baby. Is there a place where we can stay to get her out of the cold night air and give her some comfort?" The kind innkeeper said the best he could do was let them stay in his stable, where the hay and the animals would keep them warm. Finally, Joseph and Mary had a place to rest. Joseph cleaned up the stable as best as he could and made a bed of hay for Mary. During the night, there in the stable, the baby was born. They named him Jesus, as the angel had said. Mary wrapped him snugly in strips of linen cloth. Joseph found an empty feeding box the animals used, called a manger. He filled it with soft straw for the baby to use as a crib. There was no other place for the heavenly babe to sleep.
Thank you.
Outside the village, shepherds had just finished a long day of taking care of their sheep. They were sitting around the campfire, eating dinner and watching over their flock. When suddenly, an angel appeared. The shepherds were terrified and hid their eyes. But the angel said, "Fear not. I bring you good tidings of great joy. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." The shepherds followed the brilliant new star. Meanwhile, in faraway lands to the east, three wise men were each gazing at the same brilliant star. None of them had seen the star before. It glowed more brightly than all the other stars in the sky. They set out to follow that star. They knew that it would lead them to the newborn king. At the stable, the sound of the animals mingled with the sweet cries and coos of the tiny baby Jesus. Mary and Joseph's heart were filled with wonder as they looked down on God's son, their baby Jesus. Peeking their heads inside the stable door, the shepherds saw Mary and Joseph and walked in softly to see this new baby. Just as the angel had promised, one wise man peeked in, and he saw Mary, Joseph, and the baby. The three wise men entered, bringing with them their wonderful gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. The shepherds knelt before the manger in worship, and the donkey and the lamb and all the other animals bowed their heads to honor baby Jesus. Now the shepherds and the wise men followed the brilliant star in the sky to find their way to baby Jesus. But you and I don't need a star in the sky. Jesus Christ is our light, and if we follow him, he will lead us safely through this life back to our heavenly home. The birth of Jesus brought the good news of God's love to the world. God's love of the special baby Jesus came to everyone, to young and old, to rich and poor, to all races and nations. This is the Christmas season, the joyous time of year when we celebrate the birth of this blessed baby in a humble stable long, long ago.